Dr. Balan Jalal here. So I wanted to cover the, you know, the topic of belief. Now, we tend to get told that life is supposed to be a certain way, that we can only achieve certain limited things in life. And I was no different. In fact, my parents came to Europe, to Denmark, as refugees. Our first home in Denmark was a refugee camp. And I grew up in a ghetto-like area where things were very tough. I mean, I remember seeing alcoholics, drunk people so often that I thought being drunk was normal. And of course, this environment affected the level of inspiration that I had, my ability to perform in school. I was lacking in motivation and inspiration, frankly. I used to, like, you know, just sit there in class and just daydream and just fantasize about the lunch break. That was the highlight of the day, where I could go out and play soccer with my friends. And this kind of behavior continued all the way to high school. I nearly got kicked out of high school several times. And, you know, it was a miracle that I even graduated, let alone, you know, believing or you're thinking, imagining that one day I would become a neuroscientist and I would study the human brain. That was totally out of the picture. In fact, biology was probably the most boring subject of them all, right? You know, studying cells and studying neuroscience. Now, what happened to me after graduating high school, at some point something changed for me, something shifted. I became curious about the human brain and about human psychology, you know, because it was interesting. You know, instead of me being told in school that I had to read certain books, now I was doing it because I actually found the subject interesting. So I became interested in knowledge for its own sake, and that changed everything for me. I mean, I became obsessed. I would just devour books and read books, you know, like an obsessed person, really. So that was really what that happened to me. And then, now at this point in my life, I decided that, look, I want to pursue scholarship, you know, at a higher level. And, you know, in spite of those limiting beliefs that I've had as a kid growing up, I was able to rise above those. I mean, it's kind of like, I mean, I think you can relate, right? So we have these limiting beliefs, but we can always sort of, you know, overcome them and pursue what we want to do, you know, in life, even though it's difficult. So for me, that meant traveling to Egypt. So I went to Egypt. I lived there for a few years in the United States. Obviously, I lived there for several years and in the United, you know, the UK. And on this journey, I was fortunate. I would meet mentors at various stages of my career who would guide me along my journey. They would instill in me belief that I could do something greater, and that was hugely, you know, important to me. I mean, my mentor in California, V.S. Ramachandran, was extremely instrumental in guiding my career. He took me under his wing at a very early age, and really guided me as a friend more so than a, you know, an academic mentor, and that's important. Having mentors like that is something that I'm extremely grateful for. Now, I think the point is, hard work is always required to reach any kind of success in life, right? But once you have, you know, once you are passionately driven and you are curious about what you're doing, right? There's some level of curiosity driving your behavior, then that hard work won't feel like hard work, and you are able to sort of sustain that over long periods of time. And I think that's hugely important. And I guess the punchline of all of this is, you know, whatever you're going through in life, whatever circumstances that you are experiencing, you know, you probably have conditioned beliefs, right? You have conditioned way of thinking that is driving your behavior and driving your beliefs about what is possible. But you can rise above that and, you know, find out what your calling is in life, what, you know, what makes you come alive, what, you know, makes you, what drives your passion, and go do that, and let no one tell you that it's not possible. So I hope this video inspires you and that you can take something from it. And that's all I had for you today. Thank you.